Hey, and welcome to the MixPre sound device demo. We're going to be showing you how to hook up this MixPre sound device. It's a mobile mixer to two microphones, put those mics on separate channels, and run them through a snake that comes with the MixPre sound device and into an HVX 200 camera or any camera of your liking that has two XLR inputs. All right, we're going to start with the star of the show, the actual MixPre sound device. It's a mobile mixer you'd use on location. Let's just get in for some close-ups here of some of the buttons and dials that are on this that you'll be using.
Here we have the power switch, and above it is the power LED indicator. This is the headphone volume control dial, and above it is the headphone peak LED indicator. Beside it is a quarter-inch headphone connector. Here we have a tape return switch. Toggling this switch allows you to switch between hearing the MixPre's mix versus hearing the mix coming out of the camera. This is the meter brightness control. Next we have the slate tone oscillator switch. This switch sends tone to the camera. These two switches are called pan switches. They delegate where each mic input is sent, left, right, or center. These two dials are your gain control for your two mic inputs. Above them are your input peak LEDs. Here we have a built-in slate tone microphone used to talk to the camera operator. Finally, we have our output level meters measured in dBU. As I turn the MixPre to the left side, you see the input face. Here we have our limiter switch with its threshold level control. Beside that, we have the phantom power switch used to send power to microphones if required. Next are two XLR microphone inputs. Here we have our tape out 3.5mm headphone jack, and beside it is our tape return level control. As we look to the right face of the MixPre sound device, you see an external DC power input, a battery compartment, two XLR outputs, one delegated left and one right, and finally our tape return input.
All right, now that we know a little bit about our MixPre sound device, we're gonna show you how to hook up two mics to it first. We have our input one on our MixPre here, input two. We're gonna be hooking up a shotgun mic here that requires phantom power, and we're gonna be hooking up a dynamic mic here that does not require phantom power. All you gotta do, simply plug one end of your XLR into your mic, and the other end, this one we're gonna put into input one. Like that. Now our shotgun is going into input one. Simply take the other XLR, which is already plugged into the other end of the mic here. We're gonna plug her in to input two. That simple. All right, now that we got our mics hooked up, we're gonna show you this fancy snake here. It's a very useful cable that will completely connect every aspect of your MixPre into your camera. All right, as you can see, I've separated the two ends of the snake. This end here is for your MixPre. It simply plugs in to the two inputs here. We're gonna make blue output one, which is also left output. And we're gonna make red output two, which is the right output. This here is a 3.5mm headphone jack. It goes into the tape RTN slot. This is simply for your headphones later down the line, as you can see on this end. I'll explain more about that later. Here in our camera, we have input one and input two. We're simply gonna take from our snake, input one, the blue one, put it in input one. The red one from input two from the MixPre goes into input two on the camera. That simple. Here we have that weird headphone connector. Right over here on the back of the HVX is our headphone input. So we just plug that in right there. The last thing we need to do with this here, I have some headphones. I'm just gonna take the cable from the headphones here and plug it right into there. All right, just to reiterate what we've done from the other end of the snake, we got our headphones here. They're plugged in to the snake, which is plugged into the camera on this end. You follow the snake down. Goes into our mix pre device here. The outputs. And on the input side, we of course have two XLRs going to our two microphones. Now we're going to show you how to properly set up the mix pre sound device to get good sound going out to your HVX200. All right, so as you set up the mix pre, if you're the audio operator, you're going to want your own set of headphones. We already plugged one into the camera operator, but we're going to set up plugging our own to the mix pre here so we can get our own levels. The next step before you turn on the mix pre is figuring out your mic placement. We have our talent here. We're going to give him this handheld mic right here. So basically, proper placement of a handheld mic is about 4 to 6 inches away from your mouth, angled towards the mouth. You don't want it down here, you don't want it over here. Right there, perfect. So he'd hold that there. As the audio operator, you will hold the shotgun mic off screen, obviously, over here. Point it towards your subject. Adjust your levels accordingly on here. So now we'll show you how to adjust your levels and turn this guy on. So first thing you do, flick it to interior power if you're gonna be using battery power. The next step here is to check that these are on separate tracks, left and right. Input one here, a shotgun, is now has a separate level than our dynamic mic here, because they are on the, this one is on the left track and this one is on the right track. The final thing that you need to check is that you have phantom power on if you require it. It's just over here on this side. So you just make sure phantom power right there is pushed up to plus 48. First thing you need to do on your camera is make sure that these are set to line level. The Mix Pre has a line level output, whereas more mics obviously have a mic level input. All right, the next thing you need to do on your camera is just make sure your inputs are set to separate channels. So input one is our left, input two is our right. All right, as you can see, we are getting levels down here from our mics. You can see they're hitting different heights and stuff, so you know you're getting two separate levels, and you can just test that in the headphones. Now, to properly set up the proper inputs, you have to go over to the mix pre and send tone. So let me do that right now. Now that, as you see, we have tone coming across here, we just turn our level dials over here so that they are both hitting the one line. There. Oh, it keeps dropping on me. As you can see now, we have our levels set up perfectly to tone. All right, so that's how you properly set up your mix pre to a HVX200 using a snake and panning two separate mics to two separate channels. I hope you learned something, and have a great day.